door to disconnect the telephone line. Relax, baby, and draw that blind. Kick off your shoes.
1, 2, 3. Is it on?
It's on.
Okay. Happy birthday, Jennifer. You're 40 years old. Now it's time to freeze up.
Is it? Mm-hmm. Happy birthday, Jennifer. You made it to 40. Maybe you can make it to 90.
What are you going to say for her 90th birthday?
Oh, happy birthday.
You going to say something for her 90th birthday?
Yeah, I plan on being here.
You're optimistic.
You have to be. Well, I'll be robots by then.
This is true. All right.
Emily said we're supposed to tell stories.
Funny stories.
Or an interpretive dance.
No, there's not going to be any dancing involved.
So you're going to tell them the Waylon story, right?
The Waylon story? Well, Jennifer knows the Waylon story, and now Emily knows the Waylon story. But for all of those that have not heard it, this Waylon was a friend of Jennifer's who is the son of my best friend, Gayla Davis. And Waylon and Jennifer were about 4 or 5 years old. And we're over at Gayla's house visiting. And Waylon and Jennifer are off in the other part of the house somewhere while me and Gayla are in the living room. Gayla says, well, I'm going to go check on the kids and see what they're doing. And a few minutes later, she comes back and she says, oh my God, Susan, they were in the bed with no clothes on. So she goes running back in there to tell them to get their clothes on. And that was the end of that.
You said you had forgotten about that story?
Yeah.
On purpose?
Probably, yeah. I forgot all the stories now.
Oh yeah, there was another one that I almost forgot about. Is Jennifer was again about the same age, I guess. I guess she went through this spell.
And what you call it?
There was one of your friends. One of your friends was over at the house, and Jennifer was sitting in David's lap, and all of a sudden, without warning, she just jerks her shirt up. See my titties?
So she was a little bitty prevert.
Yeah, in her younger days.
Her younger days, okay. How about when she was born? Y'all have any stories about that?
A little bit, maybe. It's kind of uneventful, really. But
well, that's good.
But anyway, I was kind of waiting around that night, you know, till time to go to the hospital, and finally decided it was time. I take a shower and get my bag and wake David up and say, let's go. So we get out to the car and I get on my side of the car and David says, I gotta lay down. He just falls out in the ground. Lays there for a minute and gets back up and gets in the car and we take off.
Were you nervous?
Yeah, just a little bit. I thought that was when Jennifer cracked her head on the refrigerator door.
That's when she's born. Of course, I could be wrong.
That was the refrigerator door.
Remember that
big pump knot come up on her head? I thought it was going to explode.
Oh, gross.
Yeah, she hit the very corner of the refrigerator.
Yeah.
This explains a few things.
She hit her head a lot. Like the time that they were playing blindfold something over at Jada's house, and she
ran
into the side of the house. Just screwed up her whole face and forehead, and she had black eyes for a week.
Hey, girls. She don't like you biting on her butt, evidently.
Who, Jennifer or the cats?
Lucky bit Lucy on the butt, and she got up and attacked her.
You got anything to say?
Well, happy birthday, Jennifer.
Happy birthday. I'm so glad that you ended up being smarter than us.
Oh.
Amen.
We love you.
You a happy birthday, happy 40th. We've known each other for as long as I can remember. And I just feel so blessed to have you in my life. And I can't say much more. I'm probably going to cry. So just have a great birthday, and we're going to have fun at your party. And I love you. And you're a sister to me. So, I love you. Happy birthday. Mwah.
Oh, for happy birthday from me and...
What's up? Happy birthday.
Hope it's a good one.
Debbie just hit the wall. She never had it all. One Prozac a day. Husband's a CPA. Her dreams went out the door when she turned 24. Only been with one man. What happened to her plan? She was gonna be an actress. She was gonna be a star. She was gonna shake her ass on the hood of Whitesnake's car. Her yellow SUV is now the enemy. Looks at her average life and nothing has been alright. Since Bruce Springsteen, Madonna, way before Nirvana, there was U2 and Blondie, and music still on MTV. Her two kids in high school, they tell her that she's uncool, cause she's 1985. She's seen all the classics. She knows every line. Breakfast Club, Pretty in Pink, even St. Elmo's Fire. She rocked out to Wham. Not a big Limp Bizkit fan. Thought she'd get a hand on a member of Duran Duran. Where's the mini skirt made of snake skin?
You are 40 years old, which means I'm still 39, and you're fucking old. That sucks. Now you have a real reason for that whole resting bitch face. Anyhow, when I met you, the first time I met you that I know of, I remember they were doing our tests at West Haven, and my mom and your dad were over there talking, and Jada was in there with us, and we were supposed to have Mrs. Toppins, but she ended up, because she was pregnant, she ended up leaving at the last minute, and we only had her like 3 days that year. Anyhow, that was the first day we met, and we were having to walk on a balance beam, which I couldn't do then, and do a bunch of other crap just to see, essentially, if we were smart enough for kindergarten. Well, we must have been okay. We both ended up in there. Things I remember, as far as funny stories, the key, the magical key at the playground, and, oh, I am drawing a blank right now. I got plenty. Too many. I think that's the problem. There was the time that you accidentally caught me losing my virginity. accidentally. You've been there for literally everything that has ever happened to me, pretty much. You were the one that introduced me to both of my high school sweethearts. You were the one... You were the one that introduced me to my husband. You have been there for everything. No matter what was going on at the time, we've always kind of known this is this and this is how it is. And we may have occasionally had our doubts, but you are my sister. And tell your family I'm sorry. But you're my sister. And I'm your sister. And I love you. And happy birthday. And let's get drunk, bitches! Love you.
She's in love with herself. She likes the dark. And on her milk white neck, the devil's mark. Now it's All Hallows Eve. Moon is full. But will she trick or treat? I bet she will.
Happy birthday, Jen. You don't look a day over 29. I gotta say, we are aging very well. And I hope that I am there with you to celebrate your birthday today.
my first memory of Jennifer was remembering seeing Jennifer and Emily smiling and laughing together, sitting on the wall at West. And Jennifer always had a smile, epic hair, and I don't remember Jennifer being without Emily or Emily being without Jennifer. The two of them were like this, like two peas in a pod. And I hope you have an awesome birthday.
This is ponderous, man. Really ponderous. I had this dream the other night. I went to work one day, and nobody remembered who I was. So, I decided to take the day off. On my way out, I run into my boss, and he says, "Hey, you look familiar." I said, "Thanks. People say that a lot in these dreams." And the horns kicked in. My shoes started to squeak. Then all of a sudden, I'm standing on a beach in some tropical part of the world, and there's a sign that says, "Aren't you supposed to be at work?" Sort of screamed out at me. And I remember, I'd been here in other dreams. Usually there was a water polo game, and a girl who could talk with her eyes, and she'd say,
"Can you see what I'm saying?"
And the horns kicked in, and my shoes started to squeak. Before I knew it, I was walking near a lake when a phone rings.
"John, I hope you have a great birthday."
"Say love you."
"Love you."
Well, what can I say? Well, ever since the first time you and Dave walked into the shop, my whole life changed. From there, I met some of the best friends I've ever had. I met my husband, Mikey. Well, Jen, you're sort of our, I guess, Kevin Bacon of the group. It all links back to you. Anyways, I thank you for that. My life would be completely different if we hadn't met. And, the day you and Dave walked in the shop was obviously life-altering, to say the least. Anyways, I hope you have a wonderful birthday. I love you bunches, and I guess that's it. Bye.
I don't know what to say except for happy birthday, and I know I knew you before then, but thanks for going into Jess's shop and making that wonderful connection for me. I love you, you and Dave and everybody, but I hope you're having a happy birthday, and I hope you have many, 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 many more, and I don't know what else to say except glad I met you, and happy 40th.
Oh, Lord.
Get drunk and get loud. Everybody wants to get drunk and get loud. And all my rowdy friends have settled down.
Well, you're always talking about how old I am, but now that you're almost 40, I can't think of anything to say that talks about how old you are. So I decided to give some historical facts from 1976. 1976, gas was 59 cents. The Apple Corporation was formed.
Dad, this is giving me troubles.
Yeah, I know. It's old. Big Red Gum came out. Hotel California was released. The official premiere of The Muppet Show came out in 1976.
I thought that was old.
That is old, daughter. U2 was formed. The Steelers beat the Cowboys in Super Bowl X. Peyton Manning was born in 1976.
Go Balls!
Yeah. The Blues Brothers and Laverne and Shirley came out in 1976. On November 21st, 1976, Rocky actually premiered in movie theaters.
Yo, Adrian, here's Rocky.
The U.S. celebrated its 200th birthday.
Is Mom 200 years old?
No, son, Mom's not 200 years old. She's 14,600 days old, though.
Wow, that's old.
Yes, daughter, that really is old. I tried to find somebody who had a birthday with you in 1976 on November 21st, but I couldn't actually find anybody.
I did dirt!
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday! We love you!
Thank you.